Hey guys, welcome back to my channel for another video. If you're new here, welcome. If you're a returning subscriber, welcome back. Before I go into the video, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and please subscribe if you have not already. In today's video, we're going to use our scalp treatment from the previous video and make a gel. Do you see how the texture of this gel is? It is simple and easy to make. If you have not already seen the video that I made the scalp treatment, you can go ahead and click the link up above so you guys will know how I make it and all of that jazz. So guys, I had some clove tea in the morning and that's my leftover clove tea. Yes, I do have clove tea now and then because I believe taking things internally is also great for the overall health of your body, and you're gonna have healthy hair as well. So guys, let's get into the ingredients. As you can see, I have the clove tea and I also have the leftover scalp treatment which contains cinnamon and clove in it. I'm going to use some xanthan gum and I'm also using some glycerin along with some green tea extract. So guys, if you do not have green tea extract, it's totally fine. You can use some peppermint oil or any type of essential oil of your choice. I chose to use the green tea extract because I had it handy, so I just add it to the mixture. So we're gonna go ahead now and get all of that mixed together to show you guys how I came up with this beautiful gel for your hair. So guys, this is the ingredients that forms the jelly form in the product. So you need some xanthan gum or you can use some guar gum for this. And this is the reason why the product is jelly form, right? And you're going to mix that up with some glycerin. I find that using glycerin, when you mix the xanthan gum with the glycerin, it mixes it out pretty well, as you're gonna see. If you try to mix the xanthan gum in the mixture by itself, you will have clumps and it's gonna be just a headache to get all that clumps out, and the gel will not be as smooth as you want it to be because you're gonna have some clumps in it. So you guys can see how well it mixed out. Then you're going to add it to the mixture and you're going to mix slowly until it starts to thicken up. If you watch closely guys, you're gonna see how that it's getting thicker when I am mixing it up. If you want your mixture to be thicker, you can add more of the guar gum or the xanthan gum, whichever gum you're using, and it will be much thicker. This texture was perfect for me. And I went ahead and I add the green tea extract to this and I'm just going to mix this up and it's gonna be all done and ready to go into my hair. We're gonna go to that in a sec. As you guys can see, the texture is beautiful, simply beautiful. Let me know down below guys if you have ever tried to attempt making any type of jelly form product. I know that a lot of persons like to make flaxseed gel. I had done that on my channel before. I will leave the link for you guys if I remember. And yeah, you guys, flaxseed gel is a pain to make. To squeeze it out, too much work. This is just easy and simpler to make. So now that the gel is finished, I'm pouring it into the container. Look at the texture, guys.
Thank you.
And yes, I did use the entire jar of this gel, simply because I did not want to store it. I didn't want to put any preservatives in it to store it. So I used the entire jar. I can always make it because it's so easy to make, as you can see. Like, it's not hard to make. So I can always make a fresh batch each time I want to do it. I will definitely be using this as a pre-poo to soften my hair when I feel like my hair is so thick and tangled. I will definitely be running for this DIY. As you guys can see how it's just gliding through, my finger just gliding through my hair, and my curls are loving it. My curls are definitely loving it. So guys, I did left this in my hair for about 45 minutes, then I rinsed it out and continue with my wash day. And just another tip guys, I always add oils to my routine. Whenever I am deep conditioning or I'm pre-pooing, I always add oil to it. That's just a thing that I do. And yeah, I hope that you guys enjoy the video, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye guys.